What I'm going to do next is to introduce a few additional coverage criteria using a slightly more complex example, but still a pretty simple one. What I'm showing here is a program that reads two real numbers, x and y, and then if x is equal to 0 or y is greater than 0, it computes y as y divided by x. Otherwise, it computes x as y plus 2. Then it writes the value of x, the value of y, and it terminates. Let's also introduce a CFG for that program. As you can see, the CFG represents the statements in the code and their control flow. And in this case, I made explicit over the branches what are the conditions under which those branches are taken to make it simpler to look at the example. Let's assume that we have two tests for this code that are shown here. For the first one, the inputs are 5 and 5. For the second one, 5 and minus 5. If we consider branch coverage for this code and we consider the two test cases, for the first one, this condition is true because x is not equal to 0, but y is greater than 0. And therefore, we will follow this true branch. For the second one, the condition is false because x is not equal to 0 and y is not greater than 0. Therefore, the negation of it is true and we will follow this branch. In other words, these two test cases achieve 100% branch coverage on this code. If we look at the code, though, we can see that there is the possibility of making this code fail. Consider this statement. If x is equal to 0, we could have a division by 0. However, these two test cases, despite the fact that they achieve 100% branch coverage, will not reveal this problem. So how can we be more thorough? I'll let you think about it for a second. So think about how can we test more thoroughly, in a more complete way, this code. So in a way that goes beyond branch coverage. And the answer is that we can make each condition true and false instead of just considering the whole predicate here. And that's exactly what is required by the next criterion that we're going to consider, which is condition coverage. We're going to define it as usual in terms of test requirements and coverage measure. In this case, the test requirements for condition coverage are the individual conditions in the program. So we want each condition in the program to be both true and false for some execution. So the way in which we can measure that is by measuring the number of conditions that were both true and false when we executed our tests over the total number of conditions. And that gives us the percentage of coverage that we achieved for condition coverage. Again, if we want to look at this criteria in the form of a question, the question will be, has each Boolean sub-expression, which means every condition in every predicate, evaluated both to true and false when we run our tests?